cohort, the Debaters channel lovers. Thank you so much for watching, subscribing, liking, sharing, and commenting. I've got an exciting recipe here. Not your usual Ghana buff roots or puff puff, not your usual one. So I'm going to take you through the ingredients so we can start. So we are making Ghana puff puff, but on the next level. I bet you would love it, more healthier and nicer. So I've got a chunk of flour here. It's a plain flour. I've got my nutmeg, one large banana, my oil, vegetable oil for frying. I've got my teaspoon of vanilla essence. I've got my turmeric here. I've got cinnamon powder, yes, brown cinnamon. I've got my sugar, and I've got my baking soda, my baking powder, a pinch of salt, and most importantly, my yeast. So let's start, my lovely people. So I'll put my flour aside and get my yeast in this container and add my hot water to get it to incorporate and rise for our flour. So as you can hear, I've popped the kettle on, so it will heat my water whilst I mash my banana to start our recipe. Yes. So I'll peel off my large banana into my container. Yeast to rise whilst I do all this. I'll put this aside whilst I mix up my yeast. Yes, I'll put my banana aside for now and get my yeast here. Go for my water. I'll get 1 tablespoon of sugar, mix up with my yeast, and then pop my water in whilst I mix very well. Mixing very well. I'll leave all the measurements in the description box, so you don't need to worry about any measurements at all. Yeah. At this point, I'm sure my yeast is all melted and mixed up with my sugar. I'll add more water, just a bit. Yes, this is just how I want it. I'll get my cling film to cover our yeast to get it to be warm, settled, and set and be all bubbly later on. So I'm going to keep this aside for 15 minutes whilst I mix all my other ingredients. I would also cover this with my tea towel to get the heat trapped in there, so my yeast is all done and clean. So I'll put this aside. This goes here. And now back to our banana, which is almost mixed up and mashed nicely. This is to bring a very dicey and nice taste, as well as replacing a portion of sugar in our recipe. Yes, it makes us use less sugar instead of adding more sugar. Use the banana to replace that, as well as getting this nice and dicey exceptional taste. If you try this, you would know what I'm talking about. Yes. So banana is all mashed up. I'm going to set this aside whilst I come to my dry ingredients. So my flour is here. I'll get a tablespoon of my nutmeg and even more. I'll add more of it. Yeah, and a pinch of my cinnamon, just a pinch to give it an amazing flavor and taste. I'll add my salt. My sugar. And the rest of my dry ingredients. That's my turmeric. Baking powder, baking soda. The turmeric is meant to give it that yellowish color. Beautiful golden color. Whilst giving it another amazing flavor. So I'm going to mix all this up with my hands, making sure everything is absolutely mixed up. Yes, this is how it should look, all crunchy and crumbly. So whilst mixing this, you would need a warm water. So as I've got my water already in my kettle, I'll get some cold water to get it a lukewarm. Yeah, so this is my cold water with a pinch of hot water. Mashing it bit by bit. Don't put all the water all at once, so you don't find yourself wanting when you need to add more water. I still need more warm water. See how the turmeric made the color look. Oh my goodness, it looks so yummy already. So at this point I'll add my mashed banana, every bit of that. Mix it until it's smooth. It still can be thrown about. I'll add my vanilla syrup at this point, just a teeny tiny pinch of it. So if you want your puff puff or buff fruits very dense, you make it harder. But if you want it fluffy and soft, you add more water to get that texture you would want. I don't want it too dense, so I'll add a pinch of water whilst I'm finishing up this. Still leaving room for my yeast, which is getting ready to be added to this. I'll go check up on my yeast to see how it is going. So our yeast has been sitting for 15 minutes now, so I'll go ahead and add it to our mixture and leave it to rise for 30 minutes. Yeah, so this is our yeast here. I'll just open it and pour every bit of that slowly. Make sure everything mixes up well. Yeah. And this is going to sit for, after mixing everything, this is going to sit for 30 minutes covered up for it to rise. How this looks. As I said, if you want it very dense, reduce your water so you get it dense and hard. If you want it soft and fluffy like mine, you mix it according to that. Yeah, I'll add the last bit of it. My gloves is gonna stop for now. This is just how I want it. All done now. I will take off my gloves at this point, making sure there's no waste. and then cover this up with my cling film to get all the heat trapped in there for it to rise nicely. And this will sit for 30 minutes. You can go beyond that if you want, but 30 minutes should be fine, or 45 minutes. So this should be in a warm place so it can rise nicely. I'll still cover this with my tea towel whilst I wait for this to rise nicely. Yes, so our puff puff pastry has been sitting for 30 minutes now, so I will open it now. See how it looks. See how bubbly it all looks. See the bubbles? Yes, looks all ready. So I'll on my pan at the moment. Try and get rid of any air that is trapped in there. So it's got air, so you need to get air out so it's not too dense when you fry it. Look at the texture. I'm letting the air out, every bit of it. It's going to burn without cooking through if it's too hot, and if it's too low, the oil is going to suck it up. So I try to get all the air out of it just as I'm doing. Yes, like this. Try to get all the air out. Yes, fetch it like this. Catch through, throw, and then catch. And I'll drop it in my oil here, depending on the size that I want. Catch, throw, catch, and drop it here. Throw, catch, throw, catch, throw, catch. Then I'll drop them in my oil. See how beautiful they turn out. Your puff puff should float in 2 to 3 seconds as soon as you drop them in the oil. Yes, it should float by itself. That is why it's called a ball that floats. So puff fruit. That's how we call it in our local language in Ghana. So that is it. Now fetch more of this and I'll throw. Please do not overcrowd your pot so it can cook through and nicely for you. So I will not drop again at this point. I'll leave this to fry for the next 7 minutes. Whilst I turn it occasionally because I don't want it to burn on one side. So got this stick here, which is very handy. Turning it as I want. So it's cooking on both sides and not just one side of it. see how golden brown our purples look. Looks so gorgeous. And I'm excited already. Yes. If you are, please give me a thumbs up. If you like my page, please share with family, friends, and comments. Please don't scroll. I've got more exciting recipes that you can watch and learn and share with family and friends. Yes. So we are almost done with this batch. It's been frying for 7 minutes now. I'll just give it another 2 minutes and I'll dish this out and continue the process until my dough or butter is done. Turn this so it's all cooked through. Just giving it the last 50 seconds. Okay, so I'm done at this point and I'm going to dish this.
It's red.
Yes, darling. Mommy's on set. Sorry about that. Apologies. My son just came into my kitchen and that's him there. Yeah, I'll dish everything out and continue the process until my entire butter is done.